Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, most merciful, most compassionate, all praise be to Allah, peace and blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad and all the prophets from Adam to him, peace be upon them all. Today we will talk about Mevlana Rumi's perspective on nature and natural environment. Mevlana Rumi offers to us quite invaluable perspectives and insights concerning the nature and natural environment. In his eyes, nature is alive and spiritual. He has a holistic view of the universe. Mevlana indicates that everything around us, tangible, intangible, visible, invisible, organic, inorganic, from the plants to the animals, inanimates, all are in a harmonious system and functioning and moving in a proportionately well-designed networks of interrelations as divinely structured with a wisdom and for a purpose by the Creator. All that exists in the universe depend on the grace and mercy of Allah, who is high, alive. Since the Creator is alive, so is His creation. Everything has a value, has a place in the overall universe and cosmos. Everything, therefore, is very special and unique. Nature's activity in this world has a purpose and meaning. Mevlana says, all the mountains, stones, winds, and all nature declare by saying, we have hearing, sight, and we are happy. Why? Because they are the servants of Allah. Everything in nature follows the law of Allah. Everything is created anew according to this law and maintained and sustained by the Creator at every moment and for all the times. All atoms of earth and heaven, Mevlana says, are the army of Allah on putting it to the test. In the earth and the heavens, not an atom moves a wing, not a straw turns, save by His eternal and effectual command. To expound this is impossible. Presumption is not good, Mevlana says. And when asked this question, who can number all the leaves of the trees? How one can, you know, give the list of the things that Allah Almighty created? How may the infinite become amenable to speech? Hear this much. Since all action only comes to pass by the command of the Maker, it is Allah who sets the operational laws in nature, and without His will and command, nothing moves and runs. All is regulated by the Creator. Know then, Mevlana says, the subtlety in the water is not from the water. It is only the gift of the bounty's originator. If He make air and fire low, if He lets the thorn surpass the rose, He is the ruler, God, who does whatever He wills. From the very self of pain, He raises, brings out the remedy. If He make air and fire low, and make darkness and grossness and heaviness, if He makes the earth and the water high, and makes the path of heaven and traverse by foot, the universe, nature, the world are all alive. Each one of us then has a sense of duty to discern, to see this liveliness. Each one of these natural beings, things, has a sense of duty and consciousness and value. Air, earth, water, fire are, Mevlana says again, slaves, servants with you. But you know, all this air, earth, water, and fire, they appear to us dead, but with Allah, they are all alive. They are actually alive, not metaphorically. Then who can see their liveness, their alive, that they are alive? His Mevlana says, those who have insight, clairvoyance, like an eye of the heart, an internal perception, they may very well sense that they are alive. Since Allah put them all in an order, since Allah sets them in an equilibrium, then they display their recognition of Allah's power with their own modes of languages. In fact, they continue to articulate their praises and glorifications through their respective mode of expressions, as Mevlana remarks, by following the ayah of the Quran, verse of the Quran, the speech of water, the speech of earth, and speech of mud are all apprehended by the senses of those who have hearts. And Mevlana, of course, here refers to one of the verses of the Quran, and the before maybe giving this Quranic verse, let me also give a quotation from Mevlana. Mevlana reminds us of Suleiman, Solomon's, peace upon him, God-given ability with which he would speak and listen to nature. He says, look, every morning when Suleiman came and made a supplication in the Masjid Aqsa, in the farther mosque, he saw that a new plant had grown there, and he would say, tell me your name and your use. What medicine are you? What are you? What is your name? To whom are you hurtful? For whom is your benefit? Then every plant will tell its effect and name to Suleiman, saying, I am life to that one. I am death to this one. I am poison to this one, and sugar and seaweed to that one. This is my name on the tablet by the divine decree. Then from Suleiman about those plants, the physicians became learned and wise authorities. So for Mevlana, for almost all spiritual masters of Islam, nature is an open book for us, as it affords to show us not only the qualities and attributes of Allah, but meaning and wisdom for what they have been created. And water goes from above to below, is a long, again, quotation from the Masnavi, but I am making it short. And he says in the end, the inanimate matter was turned into human qualities, and saying, we came at first from the living world and have gone back from below to above. All particles in movement at rest are speakers. Truly, they are saying, to him we are returning. So praises and glorifications of the hidden particles have filled heaven with this shout, with the cry. Nature then is in intimate communication with the Creator. Mevlana basically echoes this verse of the Quran, seven heavens and earth and whatever is between them all glorify Allah. There is nothing that does not glorify Him and always praise Him, but you do not understand their praise and glorification. Allah is all forbearing and all forgiving. This is chapter 17, Isra and 44. Now, all created beings indeed are glorifiers, and compulsory glorification somehow for them. The mountains too make a song, like the Mevlana says, that of David, Dawood. And the substance of iron is wax in his hand. The wind becomes a bearer for Suleiman. The sea becomes capable of understanding words in regard to Moses, Musa. The moon becomes also able to see the sign in obedience to Ahmed, meaning the Prophet Muhammad, peace upon him. And fire becomes wild roses for Ibrahim, peace upon him. And the earth swallows Karun like a snake. The morning pillar comes into righteousness, of course, referring to the pillar that was in the mosque of the Prophet, speaking in essence to him. And the stone says, Mevlana, stone says, salams to Ahmed, the Prophet. The mountain sends a message to Yahya. We have hearing and sight, and we are all happy. With you, the uninitiated, we are mute. So Mevlana finally indicates that everything glorify Allah. At the same time, everything humbly prostrate before Allah, meaning say they make prostration. And nature, therefore, has a moral sense. Mevlana believes that nature intervened with the command of Allah in some of the prophetic events in the history, as we already mentioned. If he did not give the wind, for example, vision without eye, how was it making a distinction among the people of Ad? Because they were, you know, blown by the wind, the people of Ad. How did it know the true believer from the enemy? How did it know the wine from the gourd-shaped goblet? If the fire of Nimrod has no eye, how is it taking pains towards Abraham, Ibrahim? If the Nile had not possessed that light and sight, wherefore should they have picked out the Egyptians from the Israelites? If mountain and rock had not been endowed with sight, then how should I have become a friend of Dawood, David, peace upon him? If this earth had not possessed a spiritual eye, where should it have swallowed Karun in such a fashion? And of course, Mevlana, in accordance with the teaching of the Quran, moreover proclaims that nature observes human beings and remembers their works and their deeds. Therefore, nature will serve in the end as a witness for humanity on the Day of Judgment. At the resurrection, how should this earth give testimonies concerning good and evil without having seen, Mevlana asks. For she will relate her experiences, informations. The earth will reveal her secrets to us. Of course, referring to the famous verse of the Quran from Zilzal, يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدُّثَ أَخْبَارَهَا بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا. On that very day, the earth will declare, will speak out the activities of human beings which have taken place on it, because your Lord has inspired it. So for this reason, Mevlana says, I am making humble prostration with my head on the earth all the time, so that the earth may be my witness on the Day of Judgment. That is the really affirmation and confession made by Mevlana. Again, for that reason, Mevlana says, I am laying my head on the earth so that she will be a witness on the Day of Judgment for me. On the Day of Judgment, when she shall be made to quake mightily, this earth will bear witness to all that passed. The natural world environment fulfills its moral duty as commanded by Allah. All inanimate beings, rocks, stones, mountains, earth, all plants, all animals are, to say the least, in their very nature, conscious of their creator. Like all other existing beings, the natural world too is a blessing of Allah. It is good in itself, fully obedient to the creator, to the order of the creator. Let me conclude then by reading a set of lyrics uttered by Yunus Emre, another prominent spiritual master of Islam, and whose lyrics are excellent to describe even the topic of today's presentation. Because like Suleiman, like Mevlana, Yunus also was speaking constantly with the birds and plants. And the lyrics I have chosen for you from him, of course, he was a prominent spiritual master of Islam, as I mentioned, also contemporary of Mevlana Rumi. And lyrics were original in Turkish. You will hear from my humble Turkish-English translation, and as chanted today in many religious gatherings as a divine litany. And I will conclude after these recitation of this poetry. I am calling you, my Lord, chanting with mountains and rocks. I am calling you, my Lord, singing with birds at dawn. I am calling you, my Lord, with Jesus in the heaven, with Moses on Sinai the mountain, rod in his hands holding. I am calling you, my Lord, with Job in pains in his chest, with Jacob in tears in his eyes, with Muhammad Ahmed the Beloved. I am calling you, my Lord, with the tongues articulated by Yunus, continue to read, with the servants of God loving the truth, with the learned knowing the truth. I am calling you, my Lord. May Allah's and peace and blessings be upon you all.